Daily Evening Prayer, Tuesday, November 28th, 2023. Lord, I have loved the habitation of your house and the place where your honor dwells. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done. And we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore those who are penitent, according to your promises, declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins, and serve you with a quiet mind. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed. Now as we come to the setting of the sun and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, you are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is gracious, for his mercy endures forever. O give thanks unto the God of all gods, for his mercy endures forever. O give thanks unto the Lord of all lords, for his mercy endures forever. Who alone does great wonders, for his mercy endures forever. Who by his excellent wisdom made the heavens, for his mercy endures forever. Who laid out the heavens above the waters, for his mercy endures forever. Who made the great lights, for his mercy endures forever. The sun to rule the day, for his mercy endures forever. The moon and the stars to govern the night, for his mercy endures forever. Who struck down the firstborn of Egypt, for his mercy endures forever. And brought out Israel from among them, for his mercy endures forever. With a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, for his mercy endures forever. Who divided the Red Sea in two parts, for his mercy endures forever, and made Israel to pass through the midst of it, for his mercy endures forever. But as for Pharaoh and his hosts, he overthrew them in the Red Sea, for his mercy endures forever. Who led his people through the wilderness, for his mercy endures forever. Who smote great the kings, for his mercy endures forever, and slew mighty kings, for his mercy endures forever. Sihon, king of the Amorites, for his mercy endures forever, and Og, the king of Bashan, for his mercy endures forever, and gave away their land for an inheritance, for his mercy endures forever, even for an inheritance, for Israel his servant, for his mercy endures forever. Who remembered us when we were in trouble, for his mercy endures forever, and delivered us from our enemies, For his mercy endures forever. Who gives food to all flesh? For his mercy endures forever. I'll give thanks unto the God of heaven, for his mercy endures forever. I'll give thanks unto the Lord of lords, for his mercy endures forever. By the waters of Babylon we sat down and wept, when we remembered you, O Zion. As for our harps, we hung them up upon the trees that are therein. For those who led us away captive required of us a song and melody in our heaviness. Sing us one of the songs of Zion. How shall we sing the Lord's song in the land of our captivity? If I forget you, O Jerusalem, let my right hand forget its skill. If I do not remember you, let my tongue cleave to the roof of my mouth, if I prefer not Jerusalem above my dearest joy. Remember the children of Edom, O Lord, in the day of Jerusalem, how they said, down with it, even to the ground. O daughter of Babylon, wasted with misery, happy shall be the one who rewards you as you have done to us. Blessed shall be he, shall he be who takes your children and throws them against the stones. Will give thanks to you, O Lord, with my whole heart. Even before the gods will I sing praises to you. I will worship toward your holy temple and praise your name because of your loving kindness and truth. For you have magnified your name and your word above all things. When I called upon you, you heard me and gave me increase of strength. All the kings of the earth shall praise you, O Lord, for they have heard the words of your mouth. They shall sing of the ways of the Lord, that great is the glory of the Lord. For though the Lord be high, yet he has respect for the lowly. As for the proud, he beholds them from afar. Though I walk in the midst of trouble, yet shall you refresh me. You shall stretch forth your hand above the furiousness of my enemies, and your right hand shall save me. The Lord shall make good his loving kindness toward me. Your mercy, O Lord, endures forever. Despise not the works of your own hands. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. A reading from the prophet Isaiah, beginning with the 41st chapter, the first verse. Listen to me in silence, you coastlands, and let the peoples gain new strength. Let them come forward, and then let them speak. Let's come together for judgment. Who has stirred one from the east, whom he calls in righteousness to his feet. He turns nations over to him and subdues kings. He makes them like dust with his sword, like the wind-driven chaff with his bow. He pursues them, passing on in safety by a way he had not been traversing with his feet. Who has performed and accomplished it, summoning the generations from the beginning? I, the Lord, am the first, and with the last I am he. The coastlands have seen and are afraid, the ends of the earth tremble. They have approached and have come. Each one helps his neighbor and says to his brother, "Be strong." So the craftsman encourages the smelter, and he who soothes metal with the hammer encourages him who beats the anvil, saying of the soldering, "It is good." And he fastens it with nails so that it will not totter. But you, Israel, my servant, Jacob, whom I have chosen, descendant of Abraham, my friend, you whom I have taken from the ends of the earth and called from its remotest parts, and said to you, "You are my servant, I have chosen you and have not rejected you." Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be afraid, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will also help you. I will also uphold you with my righteous right hand. Behold, all those who are angered at you will be shamed and dishonored. Those who contend with you will be as nothing and will perish. You will seek those who quarrel with you, but will not find them. Those who war with you will be as nothing and non-existent. For I am the Lord your God who takes hold of your right hand, who says to you, do not fear, I will help you. Do not fear, you worm, Jacob. You people of Israel, I will help you, declares the Lord, and your Redeemer is the Holy One of Israel. Behold, I turn you into a new sharp threshing sledge with double edges. You will thresh the mountains and pulverize them and make the hills like chaff. You will winnow them and the wind will carry them away. And the storm will scatter them, but you will rejoice in the Lord. You will boast in the Holy One of Israel. The poor and needy are seeking water, but there is none, and their tongues are parched with thirst. I, the Lord, will answer them myself. As the God of Israel, I will not abandon them. I will open rivers on the bare heights and springs in the midst of the valleys. I will make the wilderness a pool of water and the dry land fountains of water. I will put the cedar in the wilderness, the acacia, the myrtle, and the olive tree. I'll place the juniper in the desert, together with the elm tree and the cypress, so that they may see and recognize and consider and gain insight as well, that the hand of the Lord has done this, and the Holy One of Israel has created it. Present your case, the Lord says. Bring forward your evidence. The King of Jacob says, Let them bring them forward and declare to us what is going to take place. As for the former events, declare what they were, so that we may consider them and know their outcome. Or announce to us what is coming. Declare the things that are going to come afterward, so that we may know that you are gods. Indeed, do good or evil, that we may be afraid and fear together. Behold, you are less than nothing, and your work is less than nothing. He who chooses you is an abomination. I have put one from the north into motion, and he has come. From the rising of the sun he will call on my name, and he will come upon rulers as upon Motar, and as the potter treads on clay. Who has declared this from the beginning, that we might know? Or from the former times, that we might say, he is right? There was no one at all who declared. There was no one at all who proclaimed. There was no one at all who heard your words. Previously, I said to Zion, behold, here they are. And to Jerusalem, I will give a messenger of good news. But when I look, there is none, and there is no counselor among them who, if I ask, can give an answer. Behold, all of them are false. Their works are nothing. Their cast metal images are wind and emptiness. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Seek the Lord while he wills to be found, call upon him when he draws near. Let the wicked forsake their ways and the evil ones their thoughts, and let them turn to the Lord, and he will have compassion, and to our God, for he will richly pardon. But my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as rain and snow fall from the heavens and return not again, but water the earth, bringing forth life and giving growth, seed for sowing and bread for eating, so is my word that goes forth from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but it will accomplish that which I have purposed and prosper in that for which I sent it. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Luke, beginning with the 8th chapter, the first verse. Soon afterward, Jesus began going around from one city and village to another, proclaiming and preaching the kingdom of God. The 12 were with him, and also some women who had been healed of evil spirits and sicknesses. Mary, who was called Magdalene, from whom 7 demons had gone out, and Joanna, the wife of Chuza, Herod's steward, and Susanna, and many others who were contributing to their support out of their private means. Now, when a large crowd was coming together, and those from the various cities were journeying with him, he spoke by the way of a parable. The sower went out to sow his seed, and as he sowed, some fell beside the road, and it was trampled underfoot, and the birds of the sky ate it up. Other seed fell on rocky soil, and when it came up, it withered away because it had no moisture. Other seed fell among the thorns, and the thorns grew up and with it and choked it out. And yet other seed fell onto good soil and grew up and produced a crop 100 times as much. As he said these things, he would call out, "The one who has ears to hear, let him hear." Now his disciples began asking him what this parable meant. And he said, "To you it has been granted to know the mysteries of the kingdom of God, but to the rest they are told in parables, so that while seeing they may not see, and while hearing they may not understand." Now, this is the parable. The seed is the word of God. And those beside the road are the ones who have heard. Then the devil comes and takes away the word from their heart so that they will not believe and be saved. Those on rocky soil are the ones who, when they hear, receive the word with joy, and yet these do not have a firm root. They believe for a while, and in a time of temptation, they fall away. And the seed which fell among the thorns, these are the ones who have heard, and as they go on their way, they are choked by worries, riches, pleasures of this life, and they bring no fruit to maturity. But the seed in the good soil, these are the ones who have heard the word with a good and virtuous heart, and hold it firmly, and produce fruit with perseverance. Now no one lights a lamp and covers it over with a container or puts it under a bed, but he puts it on a lampstand so that those who come in may see the light. For nothing is concealed that will not become evident, nor anything hidden that will not be known and come to light. So take care how you listen, for whoever has, to him more will be given, and whoever has does not have, even what he thinks he has will be taken away from him. Now his mother and brothers came to him, and they were unable to get to him because of the crowd. And it was reported to him, "Your mother and your brothers are standing outside wishing to see you." But he answered and said to them, "My mother and my brothers are these who hear the word of God and do it." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. For For behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed, for he that is mighty has magnified me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on those who fear him throughout all generations. He has shown the strength of his arm, he has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts, he has brought down the mighty from their thrones, and has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel, as he promised to our fathers, Abraham, and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father, almighty creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us, and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us, and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness, and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people, and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Almighty and everlasting God, whose will it is to restore all things in your well-beloved Son, the King of kings and Lord of lords, mercifully grant that the peoples of the earth, divided and enslaved by sin, may be freed and brought together under his most gracious rule, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Lighten our darkness, we beseech you, O Lord, and by your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. O God, you manifest in your servants the signs of your presence. Send forth upon us the spirit of love, that in companionship with one another your abounding grace may increase among us through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies, that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation, in the church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever.